Hey everyone, the last Swift video seemed to answer questions for many of you, but it also sparked more questions. When we were posting JSON to our endpoint, I kind of glossed over how we read JSON using Swift. So in this tutorial, I figured we'd focus just on reading JSON. So this question was posted in the comments for the last tutorial, and I figured it'd be a great place to start. Thanks, Techie Stewie Stuff, for the question. Basically, Techie is asking how to navigate the arrays and dictionaries when you load JSON. And thanks to Techie, we'll work with the JSON from the original question. I'm putting the JSON into a file in the example code, but the real starting point for reading JSON is NSData. We'll start with NSData if it's coming for a URL as well. JSON can have three possibilities. We might get back an array of items, we might get back key value pairs, or we might get a value. Things between square braces are arrays, curly braces are key value pairs. When we read JSON in Swift, we need to account for all the possibilities. An array gets loaded into NSArray, and key value pairs go into an NSDictionary. Values can go into a number, string, boolean, or it can be null. Arrays can contain objects, and objects can have values that are arrays, and arrays of arrays are values that are objects. The JSON can get complex pretty quickly. In our example JSON, our root has a single key value pair, and it starts with a curly brace. That makes it a dictionary. The root is an implied key, and the body of the JSON document is the value. Now, we can read all of this into one dictionary with the following line of code. This parses the JSON into an NS dictionary. If we didn't know the structure in advance, we'd need to check for our return JSON object to see if it was an array or a dictionary. We know it's a dictionary, so we'll just read it as such in this case. This gives us a dictionary with a single key value pair. The key is list, and everything after is the value. So let's get the dictionary the key list points to. We'll create another variable that gets the value for the key list. We'll cast the result as a dictionary. Again, if we didn't know in advance what we were reading, we'd need to check to see if the value was a dictionary, an array, or a string value. We know, so we'll hard code it as a dictionary. Here's where things get a bit interesting. Inside the list element, we have key value pairs where some of the objects are values and one is an array. To read the total value, we reference the value using the key. The values are all optionals, so we'll get the value using the bang operator. Getting the item element will return an array, so we can get the array the same way we got the total value. In this case, we'll cast the result to an NSArray. Once we have the array, we can loop and print each one. Remember, each item will always be an optional. This code assumes that there will always be a value in the optional, but if we're writing code where we don't know if there is a value, we'll need to account for that. So when we're reading JSON, we can use the NSJSONSerialization object to read the object. From there, we pull out the dictionaries, arrays, and values. The only trick is knowing what object you're getting and then unpacking the optionals when you get the values.
All right, everyone, thanks for watching. If you have any more questions, let me know in the comments. New videos come out every week, so make sure you subscribe. Liking the videos lets me know what I'm doing right. So if the tutorial is helpful for you, let me know. And with that, I'll see you in the next video.